Should you be hiking in these or these? Well, today on Backpacking TV, we're going to be breaking down all things footwear. Before we get into it, please like and subscribe to our channel. We are doing our best to educate and inspire everyone to get outside and to have fun. So if you've ever found yourself staring at a wall of footwear with all these different kinds of boots and shoes and options, not knowing what to do or what to buy or what's best for your type of hiking, well, let's look into that and let's help you out. So we have kind of a spectrum of boots here, all the way from your burly, waterproof, high-cut Gore-Tex boots. Down here, we've got our approach shoes, we've got our trail runners, and then we have our Chaco or hiking sandal. And they all have their merits. They're all reasons why you would want one over another. The most common piece of footwear that everybody really thinks of when they're thinking about hiking boots is this high-cut Gore-Tex waterproof boot. And as you can see, these are well loved. I was just out hiking and backpacking and camping in some serious mud here in the desert Southwest. And so these are looking a little bit rough right now, but the beauty of a Gore-Tex boot is that all that's it on the outside, none of it got on the inside. My feet were warm and dry the whole time. So there are obvious benefits to a boot like this. And this might be a really solid option, having that Gore-Tex boot for you. One of the things is if you're hiking with a lot of weight, if you're going to be backpacking with, say, 45 plus pounds or kind of a heavy backpack, I really recommend that you are going with this high cut style of boot, something that has ankle support as opposed to something that doesn't have ankle support. When you just put that much load on your back, your ankles are going to be a really critical part of your body's structure and stability. And having the ankle support is really helpful in making sure that you don't twist an ankle or get an injury out there on the trail. Now, should you go with something waterproof or should you go with something a little bit more breathable? That is really going to depend on your situation and where you're going to be hiking. So if you are doing a lot more desert hiking, a lot more warm climate hiking, then I'm going to recommend something a little bit more breathable. It's really important that you don't have a lot of sweat buildup inside of your boot. That's going to be a blister causing agent. If you just are sweating, if you're likely to sweat a lot, you need your feet to be breathing. You need that air kind of working its way in, or you're probably going to feel that blister action. But if you are going to be hiking in a colder environment or a wetter environment, well, then you really want to step up how waterproof your boots are and bringing that waterproofness all the way up to your high ankle so that you can be stepping in the muck no problem and having it not get inside. So those are kind of your high cut boot options, and those are great. So more of your cold weather, Gore-Tex is great for not necessarily winter, but just not really hot all the time. And then if Arizona, I like to have my feet breathe a little bit more. So having an option for letting your feet breathe and dry out, that can be a really good and helpful thing. And then you have your low cut boots or your approach shoes. Now this is something that is kind of a bit more of a niche product. Your approach shoes are typically what you see guides or climbers really like to wear. And the main difference here is that we have this rubber that is more like climbing grade rubber. And so it's really tacky, really grippy. It can wear out a little bit faster than another kind of rubber. But this is like great for gripping rock. And if you're interested in like scrambling around, then this is a great option for you. Most of these approach shoes do not have any sort of waterproofing on it outside of this little bit of extra rubber on the side. So that's pretty minimal. So if you're going to be hiking in really wet conditions, these are not necessarily a great shoe. But if you are a climber or somebody who wants to be going and scrambling a lot, this is a great shoe option for you. And I love them. They're super comfortable. And I feel like I can be Superman just climbing around and super grippy on the rocks all the time. And that's a lot of fun. Now, there is a big trend in the hiking community to actually to use something that is a trail runner. These are Ultras, and that's a brand that has become very popular. And their trail running shoe is awesome. And Terrex, Adidas makes a really awesome running shoe as well. They make a ton of running shoes. And not only are they great for running, but they are really great for hiking and backpacking. And they have become a beloved footwear option for through hiking. So if you are thinking of doing something like the Appalachian Trail or the PCT or any of these long distance trails, then having a lightweight shoe like this is actually a really good idea. So not only are they really comfortable, but they're really light. They dry out really fast. They have a lot of these kind of mesh ports where water will get in. So that is, if you're wanting to keep water out, this is not going to be a great option. But they will allow your feet to breathe. They will allow your feet to kind of refresh themselves. And if water does get in, they can then typically dry out pretty quickly. But the main thing is that they have, these have a zero drop footbed, so it's flat all the way across. It has a really nice grippy cushion, very grippy and cushiony for your footbed, so you don't have a lot of hot spots that develop. And that is a wonderful thing, especially if you're running, you have this high impact step. This is just constantly a lot of impact. This absorbs it all, and it actually translates really well to hiking and making a very comfortable hiking shoe. Now, hikers are always looking to cut weight, and so hiking with around a pound of weight on your foot is a much different experience than hiking with just a few ounces of weight on your foot. And so that's why it's become a beloved through hiking footwear option. Now, I do love hiking in these for a lot of reasons. One, they're very comfortable. My feet breathe, they feel very comfortable. They're great for hiking in rivers. If you're doing any canyon hikes when you just are mandatory in the water, these are awesome because there's not much material here. So as the water comes inside, it sheds very quickly and you're not holding on a lot of other weight. However, there is a drawback, and that is that they tend to wear out quickly. These soles are not quite as durable as something like these kinds of footbeds that have a much more tough rubber to them. So if you're putting in a lot of miles, then you might wear through a shoe in a relatively short amount of time. The other thing is that your ankles are then also going to be exposed to possibly rolling. So if you are carrying a heavier load, then this might not be that great. If you're a through hiker or a minimalist, then you're typically carrying less than, say, 35 pounds, then this is going to be a great option for you too. Last but not least is the hiking sandal. Chacos became incredibly popular in the boating and rafting community because obviously there's not much here to hold on to water, and these make a fantastic water shoe. And I love hiking in these in the desert. When it is super hot, when it is 110 degrees outside, I love just letting my feet feel naked and like they can breathe and that they are very comfortable no matter how hot it gets out there. However, obviously too, your toes are going to be exposed here, and that's not always a great thing for when it could be kicking cactuses or having a boulder fall or a small boulder or rock kind of roll onto your foot. Or if you're hiking on a lot of uneven terrain, then your ankle support is going to be quite limited in something like this. But the main concern for me with hiking is how many miles am I really going to be doing? If I'm going to be doing, this is a personal preference for me, if I'm going to be doing 6 miles or more, then I don't want to be wearing this because as these straps, they're only contacting a few points of skin on your foot. So that tends to leave my feet blistered after if I'm doing 6 or more miles in a day. If I'm doing 5 miles or less, then this is a super comfortable option. It makes a great camp shoe. It makes a great pairing with, you know, I'm hiking all day in these and then I get back to camp and then I put on my Chacos. It's very comfortable. It's a great way to go. If you're doing some casual river hiking, this is great as well. The one thing on river hiking is that I tend to get a lot of pebbles and stuff like that under my foot, in between my foot and the sole here, and that can be a little bit annoying, in which case, if there's going to be a lot of pebbles, then having something like this is actually much better at keeping my feet free from those annoyances. Okay, that's footwear. These are your options. There are tons of options out there, and if you are staring at that wall, I think that you are now more equipped to make a good purchasing decision for you. If you have any other questions about footwear or have anything that you love that maybe I didn't talk about, please do leave a comment below. I love to learn too. Although I like to think of myself as an expert, I don't know everything out there. So the world that is out there in the YouTube world, I'm sure you have some wisdom to impart to me. So make sure you leave your comments below and let me know what you think. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our channel here. We have loads of informational things and tips and adventurous stuff to get you outside and be psyched on your adventures too. So thanks so much for watching. I'm Eric Hansen. This is Backpacking TV. I'll see you later.